Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. It's me, Irvin, with another anime review. This is going to be on Made in Abyss, an anime that a lot of people have talked about for quite a bit of months. The movie just came out about a few weeks ago. I was lucky enough to get free tickets for me to go with my wife to watch the movie on a date night, thanks to Connexia or Misty Connexia here on YouTube. So thank you to him for the tickets. But today I'll be talking about the anime series, which I never did a review on, and I rewatched the series recently before watching the movie, which was kind of pointless. But I rewatched the series and figured, hey, I might as well review it in my channel. So, the anime itself follows the story of Riko, and Riko essentially is a child that is in an orphanage. She kind of was left there by her mother. She's not really an orphan, at least at the beginning of the story. Eventually, some cave people, or what's the right term? A party of people that are looking for relics, they show up and they turn in her mother's whistle and basically saying that she's dead. So then eventually she does become an orphan. So anyways, she's in this orphanage where they basically become cave raiders, where they go and get more information from the abyss. The abyss, basically this big hole in the middle of the entire city, where they just keeps on going levels by levels, and essentially each level determines how high of level of a party you are, and so on and so forth. So each of them carries a whistle, and the whistle color tells the other people in the abyss what level of expertise you are. So red ones are basically trainees. I believe the blue ones is the next level, and they're basically official raiders, I guess you can call them. The purple ones, which the leader of the orphanage has, they wear purple ones. Jiru is his name, and he's basically instructor level. I believe there is another level before that. It's essentially, I think if you have nothing, you're considered kind of like an orange level, or if you're just kind of a wanderer. I could be wrong, but I believe that's what it is. But then the top two levels, you have the black whistle is kind of like the second to best, and the white whistles are like legendary. Almost no one reaches that. Riko's mom was a white whistle, and out of the entire story, we meet another white whistle, Ozen, which was another character who helped her mother deliver Riko, as well as saving her life. And I won't talk too much about that. I will just talk about the story itself. The story itself surrounds Riko finding a boy called Reg, and they essentially go down in the abyss on a mission go in finding her mother. When her mother died and they turned in the whistle, they also turned in a letter that was given, or that was supposed to be to Riko, and part of it is says, "I'll be waiting at the bottom." So she thinks it's from her mother. She thinks it's a message for her to go look for her at the bottom of the abyss. So she actually goes with Reg, this kind of cyborg kid, which we have a lot of questions about as well, and they go looking for them. The whole season of the anime can be divided in almost three or four arcs. The first arc, I guess you can consider it the orphanage arc, where you learn a lot about the orphanage, who the kids are, their friends, Ned, Shiggy, about Jiro, and the principal, so all these characters, as well as, you know, who Riko is and who Reg is. And then the next arc, you can kind of put it in the Earth Town, or them descending or starting their descension. So you learn about some of the Black Whistles there, Torka and Hoblog, which is Riku's uncle, and you learn about, you know, how the system works, as well as them going or starting their journey to go down, about the monsters and Reg's abilities and how good and bad they are. The next arc, I guess you can consider it the Seeker Camp arc, where they end up at the Seeker Camp where Ozen is, and you learn about Ozen and her past, and Riko's past, and her mother's past, and you get this all information about them and who they are. And then after that, there really is the ending arc, is where you meet Nanachi and her beloved friend. What is her name? Midi, I believe, is her name. Midi is the product of experiments, and as well as Nanachi. So all these characters, or this arc, is the last arc of the season, and it really is the darkest arc, I would say. When I watched the movie, it was PG-13, I believe, or at least the theater that I went to consider it PG-13. And when I realized that it was a recap, essentially, or a movie based on the season, I was almost awaiting for those scenes, because that arc is the darkest. And I was wondering why it was not rated R. But, you know, it didn't show that part because the movie is split into two parts. So there's two movies coming out. Then there's a third one that I'm not sure if it's going to be based on the second season or previous to the second season. Not sure yet. The whole series is big with fan base. A lot of people really, really, really have enjoyed Made in Abyss, and it won awards. It's a great anime, and if you have not seen it, you guys, you're missing out. When I first watched it, I really, really thought, you know, this is what anime needs. It wasn't too reliant on etchiness. It wasn't lenient on we have to have this type of humor and this type of comedy, and that's what really attracted me about the anime. The art style was not a typical art style, and the scenery was just beautiful in the animation. So, music-wise was great, animation-wise, amazing. It just has everything for it. The story does move quite a bit fast-paced, in my opinion. Having four different arcs in one season of 13 episodes kind of feels like they pained up a lot of information in just those 13 episodes. And there is a lot of information. If you do miss an episode, you miss a lot. So I will recommend you guys. In fact, I watched it a second time. It does help. Watching it a second time does help, because you do miss some information. You miss some important stuff that might be very important in the second season. So I know the second season has been announced. It is not being released until, I believe, next year. So it was pushed further because they wanted to release the first two movies, and then either releasing the third movie, then the second season, or second season and then third movie. They're not sure yet. So we'll see what happens. Again, out of 10, I'm going to give this one a 8 out of 10. It is a great anime. I think it has everything to it. Why not higher? It had a little bit of too many penis jokes. I think almost every episode they had one of those type of jokes. I just thought they were weird for the most part. And it moved too fast. That's really why I didn't give it higher than an 8. But 8 out of 10 is still a great rating, and I think if you have not seen it, then you're missing out. Okay, guys, thank you so much for watching this review. If you have not done so, subscribe to my channel and hit that bell button if you guys want to know when I go live, when I post videos like this one. Guys, if you recommend me to watch any anime, either current airing, because I know the season is already, and there's a whole new season of anime, so if there's something that I've missed on my first impressions, let me know what I should be watching, as well as older anime. You know, I am now going back to 2006, 2004 anime that I missed out because I wasn't watching anime at that time. So if you have some anime that I should be watching, let me know in the comment section below. Thank you so much for all that love and support you guys give me. Again, if you want some merch, there is a link down there below in the description. And you guys can buy some anime, manga, light novels and anime merch for a very cheap price. Thank you guys so much for your love and support, and like always, don't be strangers.